to excuse how dirty she is. I have yet to connect the radio and install the hat shelf, or the parcel shelf, but it does have the original look radio with a Bluetooth setup and full speaker output, very modernized, and then this is the map light switch that needs a nut, but we're almost there. Full rear seat belts, 3-point. Larger size tires. These are 165/80 R15. I think it's about 10 millimeters difference. I'm pleased with how I managed to get a good alignment on the rear bumper too. The front was real tricky, but we don't need to go there. Yes, there's a trim ring that's gonna go here, but let's take a look at the goods. This is the overdrive light. That's the way it's been wired. It's a B20. It's been bored out 30,000ths over. It's got a C-grind cam, Makuni HSR carburetors. The paper towel on my heater hoses is to check if there were any leaks. We've got a glass bowl pump from an early B16, just because they look so much cooler. sounds real happy. The washer bottle, the dual circuit brakes. This is an ignition from a 240. It's all a lot of fun, and it's working out really nicely so far. I'm quite pleased with my work. Everything's nice and tight. The gaps are almost perfect. Wagons win. That's the way. And it's real light on the steering, too. These skinny tires. Oops. Get some speed. Brakes with the dual circuit. Speedometer reads accurately with the overdrive transmission. And there's Bruce. Set the brake. Still have some of the stickers on from the new parts. Thank you. Okay, that's Genevieve. That's been my life for the last 48 months, I think. Now that it's finished, we're gonna just be spending time getting the little things dialed in. Some of the smaller bits you saw that haven't been completely assembled yet, but she's there for the most part. And it's funny how the rear exhaust fits a little differently on the wagons because the clearance is kind of tight with the storage bin and the fuel tank being a little different than the two doors. All right, thanks for watching.